Well, hello everyone, and welcome back to Musie's Modern Dreadfuls. Yippee-ki-yay, Musie lovers. And I wanted to let you know, today is a very exciting day. As you know, I've been pre-recording these because of some very elaborate surgery, etc., etc. If you want to know more about it, wait till after the outro. But the author I'm working with right now, because I've been pre-recording and I've lined up a bunch of authors, this particular author is not only publishing their stuff on Reddit, but they've also made a collection of short stories. It's a published ebook, and every cent you spend on this author's book goes to charity. So, I definitely want to, I'll put info, if it's not in this video, I'll put it in the next video, make sure my editors put it there, but definitely support their endeavor, and they're a great author, as you will soon see. And today's little ditty is on Reddit, but I got permission. I'm not even going to try to say the Reddit name because I will butcher it. But it is called There's a Locked Door in My New Apartment. And this is part one. And in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Don't forget to subscribe, tap the bells, hit like, leave a comment, and share these works. Thank you. I moved into my new apartment like a week ago. I'd been meaning to look for a new place for a while now, but just couldn't bring myself to do it due to the long working hours and laziness. But when the oven broke for the fifth time, 5 times in 2 months, and the landlord refused to pay for repairs, it gave me a boost to move out faster. I'd been living there for about a year without a contract, since it was cheaper and close to the center, but the apartment itself lacked a bunch. It was hard finding any suitable place at first. Location and price-wise, it was a real challenge. But after a couple of days of searching, I saw one ad for a 2-bedroom apartment not too far from my own, and the price seemed like a really good deal too. So I wasted no time calling the agency. After scheduling an appointment with an agent, I met him in front of the apartment building. "Hi, I'm Nicholas." He shook my hand with a bit of a grin. The apartment itself looked pretty new, so I hoped what I saw in the picture would be the same thing I saw when I saw the actual listing, that the listing would not be deceiving. The friendly agent led me inside, and we took the elevator to the 3rd floor. "This whole place is new," he said. "They just finished building it a year ago, so everything is top notch." "And what about the owner? When do I get to meet him?" I said, staring in front at the elevator door. "Yeah, you probably won't get to meet him. He keeps to himself a lot. In fact, no one from the agency has ever seen him in person. Either he's verified and all that and just doesn't like people, I guess, or he has an assistant do everything. I'm not quite sure, but I myself haven't met him." "All you have to do is pay the rent online at this address," handing me a card, "and that's it." I simply brushed this off as a good thing. I was tired of my previous landlord coming in for monthly apartment inspections, so the thought of being able to live in a new apartment without even seeing the new landlord was very appealing. And to say the least of the thought of being able to live in a new apartment without even seeing the new landlord was appealing even more. Right this way, Nicholas unlocked the door to apartment 304. When he opened the door, my jaw dropped to the floor. I had seen the pictures online, and the apartment looked amazing. But those agencies usually polish the pics a little. You know what I mean? The pictures, they'll just upgrade them, make them look a little nicer than they actually are. What I was seeing in front of me was exactly what I saw in the pictures. No more, no less. A spotless apartment, which looked so flawless, it contrasted even the building itself, which was without blemishes itself too. The living room is over here, and right here, connected to the living room, is the kitchen. The agent perkily showed me around, but I was still barely able to focus on what he was saying, being mesmerized by the ostentatious surroundings. Everything in the apartment seemed brand new. So the price we talked about, I just want to clarify, that's the price the owner wants, right? I asked, confused as to why someone would be renting a place like this one so cheaply. Yep, that's the one, Nicholas nodded. I know, you think there's a catch, right? That's not what I was, it's okay. I'd be suspicious too, but I can assure you, everything is in order here. Let's check the bathroom. The bathroom itself wasn't very spacious, but it did have a fancy new shower, which more than compensated for the lack of size. The bedroom was very neatly organized, with a big bed with a desk on one side and the opening to the bed on the other. So this would work perfectly as a bedroom slash workspace. I mean, it was perfect. More than perfect. I mean, it was perfect as my office and sleeping space in one. And that was just in the first bedroom. This is amazing. I can't believe it's so cheap. I smiled in bewilderment. When can I sign the contract? Right away, if you like, Nicholas said perkily. Nicholas led us back to the living room and we sat at the table, after which he pulled out a bunch of papers. He explained about the bills and everything that was included in the apartment, after which he gave me the papers and asked for my ID in return. So I'll just need you to sign all of these. He pointed to all the little blanks on the papers, eagerly awaiting my signature. I signed quickly, afraid that he would change his mind if I didn't do it quickly enough. I mean, this was too good to be true, but seemed plausible. I mean, the price was reasonable, but they could have gotten much higher. I glanced up and realized there was still a door we hadn't opened down the hallway, next to the bathroom. Hey, what's that over there? I pointed tentatively. Oh, that. Nicholas' tone suddenly dropped. Probably a storage room? Probably? I chuckled. Yeah, it's been locked since the start. Owner said the room's lock is rusted and he hasn't been able to open it in ages. Apparently, it would cost a lot to take the door down and repair it and fix the frame. If you need a place for some extra things, you can always get storage in the basement for tools and bikes and what have you. Will that be a problem for you? No, not at all. I shook my head, not taking my eyes off the sturdy looking door. In the end, who cared about one tiny room in this two-bedroom apartment? much to the grumbling of my previous landlord, who felt that I should leave the deposit to him due to furniture damage, and that I also gave him a last minute notice, I happily agreed. Sure, you can keep my deposit, telling him in return for the deposit that I would call the IRS and inform them of taxes he avoided by not making a contract. He dropped the idea and returned the deposit money without any further issues. What a guy. And with that, that is the first half of part one, but the videos can only be so long because, well, you know, videos. It's not as engrossing unless, well, I have to, you know, I want to make sure that you can picture everything the way I'm picturing it, etc., or describing it well. And again, this will be a mini series. And like I was saying about the author, I don't know the gender. Oh my gosh. I feel the person is published. I'll give you the link. Not in this video, it'll be in the next video. I need to get it to my editor right now because I am pre-recording. I have all the surgery. You know, you all know it. I also wanted to let you know, as I was changing, separating my vloggy family fun stuff from my creepy pasta, sci-fi, etc. stuff, I kept repeating over and over, you know, hey, we're over here now, and it doesn't matter. Now everybody knows, and new people will know. This is from Reddit No Sleep, and it is going to be a series, so please check back. We post twice weekly. Now, if there's ever a week skipped, know that somebody on this little team of ours must be unwell. And I have been going through oral surgery, but I'm recording in advance. There's stories, like there's one by Joey Horst. He wrote me a long time ago. And I just want to make sure that nothing can happen because I'm still going through the oral surgery and where, you know, you have to skip for 2 weeks. And I'd hate for that to happen with this story either. In the meantime, I'm going to let you go. Check back. You will get the other half of part one in the next video. And until then, my friend, stay spooked and stay safe and stay hydrated. All right. Talk to you very soon. Have a great day. Bye.